वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट फॉर HSC ऑनलाइन लेक्चर इनिशिएटिव टेकन बाय शेत विद्या मंदिर इंग्लिश हाई स्कूल एंड जूनियर कॉलेज ऑफ साइंस एंड कॉमर्स। आई मिस रागिनी सिंह, असिस्टेंट लेक्चरर ऑफ बायोलॉजी, एंड टुडे वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद अवर चैप्टर ह्यूमन रिप्रोडक्शन पार्ट 4। सो बिफोर आई प्रोसीड आई रिक्वेस्ट यू ऑल टू बी सीटेड विद द नोटबुक पेन एंड अदर स्टेशनरीज। Before we proceed, let's recall what we studied in the last module. In the last module, we started with the female reproductive system, in which we studied the pair of ovaries, pair of oviducts, uterus, and in today's module, we are going to continue with the uterus and vagina. So this was the diagram that we studied, a pair of ovaries. The main function is to produce the egg and to release the or to secrete the female sex hormone, that is the estrogen and progesterone. Along with estrogen and progesterone, it also secretes the remaining three hormone. Every month the ovary is releasing one egg, and that is been catched by this fimbriae of the fallopian tube, where it goes to infundibulum. From infundibulum it goes to ampulla, and from ampulla to isthmus, and then to the uterus. The uterus, this is the central part, which is the uterus, and it consists of three parts: dome shape, body shape, and the cervix. Here the cervix, it has two orifice or the two opening, internal OS and the external OS. And finally, this is connected to the vagina. Very important point of the fallopian tube, that is also called as the oviduct, was that the egg gets fertilized in the ampulla portion of the fallopian tube, and once it is fertilized, then after few days the implantation takes place in the uterus. So in today's module we will continue with the uterus part. We are dealing with the reproduction chapter, and in that specifically we are dealing with the sexual reproduction. As studied, uterus is also called as the womb. It is hollow, muscular, pear-shaped organ located above and behind the urinary bladder. It is about 7.5 cm long, 5 cm broad, and 2.5 cm thick. So this is the portion of the uterus, which is almost a muscular-shaped organ, 7.5 cm long, 5 cm broad, and 2.5 cm thick. Three parts, that is the fundus, this one, body, the central one, and the cervix. The cervix portion consists of internal OS and the external OS. Now when you talk about this uterus itself, specifically this part, it consists of the three layers. Now in this uterus, if you talk about the outer layer, this one which I am highlighting with the red, it is the perimetrium. Internal to the perimetrium there is myometrium, and internal to myometrium there is endometrium. So your uterine wall consists of three layers: outermost perimetrium, middle thick muscular, if you look at this portion, this is very very thick, and it is called myometrium. It is made up of thick layer of smooth muscles. Now whenever you talk about smooth muscle, we are very much clear that it is not under our control. It means its function is involuntary and it is not voluntary. So what is the main function of this myometrium? It plays a very important role during parturition, that is the childbirth. When it's a time for the baby to come out, this myometrium starts contracting. It gives a vigorous contraction of the muscles, causing labor, and finally the childbirth takes place. The innermost layer is called endometrium. This one innermost is called as the endometrium or mucosal membrane, and it is made up of stratified epithelium. Different types of epithelium we have studied in 11th standard chapter animal tissues. The thickness of this layer regularly undergoes changes during menstrual cycle. It means when there is a menstrual cycle, that is day 1 to day 5, which we are going to study in the coming module, the endometrium becomes very very thin, and later on once the menstrual cycle is over and again the endometrium has to become thickened, this endometrium thickness increases. So it entirely depends upon the menstrual cycle. It is richly supplied with blood vessels and uterine glands. This provides nourishment to the developing fetus. This is the most important part of the uterus. This is the reason, one of the reason also, that for the 9 months we were actually placed here. This was our house for the exact 9 months in our mother's womb. That is the uterus. So your uterus consists of three main parts. If I start from the beginning, fundus, body and cervix. If you talk about the muscular layer, it consists of three layers: outer perimetrium, middle myometrium, which is the thickest, and inner endometrium. Out of these three, the middle myometrium is responsible for the contraction, as it consists of the smooth muscle during parturition, which is also called as the labor pain. I hope till now everything was clear. Let's move ahead. This is the diagram of the smooth muscle. Now smooth muscle, if you talk about this, it is spindle shape, where you can see the apex is the narrow, whereas the central portion is broad, and in the center consists of the nucleus. So wherever this smooth muscle is present, if the function is not under our control. Look at this diagram, very clear. This is the single layer, whereas this is the multi-unit smooth muscles, and they are attached to the nerve fibers. That's the reason digestion is not under our control. Similarly, the myometrium, that is the middle layer of the uterus, the contraction is also not under our control. It will get regulated once it gets a signal. Next is stratified epithelium. Now when you talk about the stratified epithelium, the strata itself means layer. So this is the stratified epithelium, this is the basement membrane, and here there are different layers of the cells, and that's why it is called stratified epithelium. Below the basement membrane, this is called lamina propria. So stratified epithelium, strata means one above the other. Vagina. Now what is this vagina? This is the vagina which is being connected via external OS of the cervix. Let's understand one term one by one. It is a tubular female copulatory organ. As in case of male, it was the penis which was the copulatory organ. Whereas here in case of female, it is a tubular copulatory organ, 7 to 9 cm in length. It lies between the cervix and the vestibule. Now, what is the vestibule? In detail, we are going to study in the next module. This vestibule is more typically the medical word. The vaginal wall has inner mucosal lining, and because of which the mucus is secreted and it is kept moist, preventing from the other fungal infection. The middle muscular layer and an outer adventitia layer. I repeat, the vaginal wall has three layers: the inner mucosal lining, middle muscular layer and outer adventitia layer. The mucosal epithelium is stratified. It means it consists of many layer of cells and non-keratinized. Means it is, wherever the keratin is present, it is like a waterproofing substance. And whenever there is non-keratinized, means it is not waterproof, and it stores glycogen. There are no glands, but cervical secretion of mucus is received in the vagina. The opening of the vagina into vestibule is called vaginal orifice. Orifice itself means opening. This opening is partially covered by a fold of mucus membrane called hymen. Hymen is a partial mucus layer which is actually closing down, or it is covering this vaginal opening. Now hymen is of many different types. The details is actually required when you give the exam, that is specially for your entrance exam. The vagina acts as passage for menstrual flow as well as birth canal during parturition. The main function of the vagina is basically for the menstrual flow, that is menstrual cycle, as well as birth canal during parturition. Whereas if you talk about the penis in case of male, its primary and secondary function is to release the urine also as well as the semen. But if you talk about the female, it has basically three different openings, out of which the one opening, that is the vaginal opening, is responsible for this menses and the birth delivery. Whereas urethral opening is responsible for the release of the urine. I hope this is very much clear to you all. See, these are the different layers where you can talk about the squamous cells, connective tissue and the smooth muscle. These are the layer of this vaginal, which is been dissected and observed under the microscope. This is the vaginal orifice that we studied over here, that is the opening, and this vaginal orifice is covered by a mucous membrane of structure called as hymen. I hope now you would have got a very clear idea. Okay, so there is something called as uterus cancer. See, what is cancerous cells? Cancerous cells are something which has lost the control division. They are unconditionally and uncontrolled. They are dividing. So if it would be have been a normal uterus, the lining would not be like this. But since it has developed the cancerous cells, it is showing this uterus cancer. Most of the uterine cancers begins in the layer of cells that form the lining of endometrium of uterus. Perimetrium, myometrium and endometrium. So endometrium specifically, this is targeted for the cancer. What are the symptoms? Abnormal bleeding between the periods, vaginal bleeding after the menopause when the menstrual cycle has stopped, and abnormal watery, blood tinged discharge from vagina and pelvic pain. How can you detect? The detection can be done by the diagnosis with pap smear, biopsy and ultrasound. Treatment involves chemotherapy, that is administration of the drug, radiation, surgical removal of uterus, also called as hysterectomy. See, these are the symptoms. Vaginal bleeding apart from menstruation, shooting pains in the pelvic portion, difficult and pain while urinating, and sudden unexplained weight loss. All this gives an indication of the uterine cancer. Once the indication of the symptoms has been given, the detection start, which actually involved, this is the transvaginal ultrasound, where actually the scene has been, you know, it has been to detect ki there is something, an abnormality or not. If nothing, then it is given a clear indication, no problem is there. But if it is there, then the further analysis and diagnosis starts. This is pap smear test done. The pap, the full form is Papnicolaou test, abbreviated as PAP, also known as PAP smear. So if the PAP test is done and if the uterus is completely normal, this is how it will look. And if the cervical, or you can say the uterine cancer, is there, then the diagnosis can be easily done. And it is always suggested for the female, that is after the age of 35, specifically after the age of 40, to regularly go for the health checkup, and especially for all this PAP test. I hope till now everything was clear. It's a time for to test your brain. Your very first question, the dash is also called the womb, and the answer is very simple, it's uterus. Second question, name the three layers of uterus. It is perimetrium, myometrium, endometrium. Your third question, what is the function of vagina? Write down your answer. If you don't know, just pause the video, try to recollect, and then check the answer. The answer is childbirth and menstrual flow. Even if you have written parturition, still accepted. So this is the two main function of the vagina. Every month, once the female reaches the puberty, menstrual cycle, and the childbirth, that is parturition. Take down the assignment. You will explain the following parts of female reproductive system along with label diagram showing ovary, fallopian tube, uterus and vagina. So make sure you write down all the notes properly, and properly you follow the notes and study it. I hope this module was very helpful to you all. Thank you so much for attending this module. We'll again come back with the next module of the same chapter. Thank you.